Hello everyone, I just wanted to quickly discuss something that's been on my mind ever since I found out about Far Cry Mad Max, I mean Far Cry New Dawn. It's been about a month from the debut trailer, and it comes out next month, so it's basically about 2 months of advertising. I'll get to what I can hope for in Hope County, but first, let me just get my gripes out of the way. I mentioned how there hasn't been a lot of advertisement for the game, other than a few videos that don't tell us too much, other than Boomer died and the world's green, and there's about 10 other channels and websites that tell us the same thing. They're not giving us too much in way of the story, other than that we have some resources and the invading group, the Highwaymen, would rather they have them. And that's about it seems. And I swear Ubisoft isn't even proud of what they're doing. Oh look, Super Bloom, and we got two bad guys who are girls this time! Ubisoft, isn't an expansion supposed to, you know, expand and have more stuff? And they only have one faction. I mean, two enemies that are related is not that much. I mean, Far Cry 5 had four, and Primal had like two factions in it that were just as willing to kill each other as they would you. Shouldn't we be worried about more factions than just the Highwaymen? Look at the Super Bloom, and look, there's a Sawblade gun that has a happy face on it! There's a reason why it's discounted. They are treating it as a standalone game when it would have been more believable just to say it was an extended DLC. I've heard it being compared to Primal as an experimentation for game techniques, and I will say no, it isn't. Primal created three separate languages for characters so that they wouldn't have to have cavemen speak in English. They created an FPS with spears, slings, and clubs, introduced, although late, a survival mechanic to make the game more challenging and fun, while New Dawn is just introducing some new guns and a skin change. It's roughly 40 bucks here in the US, but you can get a new skin if you pay 10 more dollars. A skin that you will not be able to see in first person, mind you. Oh no, Ubisoft says, you'll be able to see your character in cutscenes. Alright, so you will not be able to see your skin 95% of the time. So it's been about 17 years since Hope County got a nuke up its butt, and it has never looked more colorful. They are referencing, however, a natural phenomenon, as seen in places like Chernobyl, where after around 20 to 30 years, due to little or no human interference, plants and animals started to make a comeback. Yes, the first wave was radiated to death, but those who survived and reproduced helped absorb the radiation, especially the plant life. So New Dawn is introducing us to the Super Bloom. And that's about it. They mention it every damn time they talk about the game. Yes, it's gonna be lovely, but what will it do for us? I don't know, maybe you can pick the flowers and get cancer from eating them? As they shrug their shoulders. So they said the map is gonna be slightly smaller than 5, but we can go to set piece missions, which we'll probably see once and never again, to go kill other survivors and steal their stuff. Which makes me stand corrected, it might be taking from Far Cry Primal a bit, in the approach that we think we are the good guys because we're helping our group, but really we are just as bad if not worse than our enemies when we actually sit and think about it. And I remember people complaining and getting mad about what happened at the end of Far Cry 5, and I really don't know why. If you've played all the other Far Cry games, you know the ending is gonna be f***ed up. They always have a messed up ending. That's why I'm saying this for this one, it's probably gonna just be a realization that you're just as bad as the people trying to take you over. So messed up ending aside, you may have guessed that what I alluded to earlier, that this game has a Mad Max complex. It is much greener, yes, but for those of you who have watched The Road Warrior, you know what I'm talking about. Even in the trailer, the twins and their army roll up like Lord Humongous at the gasoline factory with their crossbows and shoulder pads. But I actually kinda like that. So what do I hope for Hope County? Well, not much. The combat goes without question, Far Cry usually has a nice combat system, but I don't see anything that's too spectacular or any different from previous Far Crys. They introduced a new kind of crafting system where you could just mash things together, which is kinda good, so it makes semi-unique weapons. But that alone isn't gonna keep the game up. Hopefully they will implement a survivor mode, like in Primal where you had to eat to heal yourself and such. So I say do not pre-order it, and if you want to go crazy shooting up things in a Far Cry game, you can just play Far Cry 5 and its online mode, which will be absent from New Dawn. Yes, that's right, they're not gonna have an online mode or map editor. Hey, you know that feature that we had in the last game, that we brought back in Far Cry 5 that we touted so much? That we wanted everyone to play, and everyone got super excited that we were bringing it back? Yes, yes, Ubisoft, yes. Well, we're not gonna have it this time. But if you just want some new colors added to the game, and if you want to see if the story holds up, well then I guess you can get it. Just keep telling yourself it's a DLC. Right now, I'm hesitant. But I've always liked the franchise, and hopefully they'll change my mind closer to release. This is Eric, the Lone Pine Wolfman, and if you guys liked the video, please click the like button and subscribe for more content. And remember, gamers, never stop learning.